Michelle, who runs Lavender Bakery, she's an expert baker, which I definitely am not, is we are making ginger biscuits. Because I'm doing a Scandinavian evening this Friday and we're making them together. So we've rolled out the gingerbread dough, which I'll put the recipe on my blog. And in fact, the recipe is here somewhere. Can't find it. Okay, great. Well, I'll list that. And she's teaching us also how to make icing piping bags out of paper, which means that you could be anywhere. It's a great survival baking skill. You can be anywhere in the world and make a piping bag.
Indeed.
A bit of old newspaper if you need.
Yes. Okay, so from a rectangle, you cut two pieces like so.
Yeah.
So they go sort of opposite each other, like that.
Do this nice and slow, okay, for those of us who are a little bit less coordinated.
Okay. Let's roll it. So you hold it with that hand.
Yes.
At the front, you're finding the point that's at the bottom, the long bit there. So you turn it round, roll it round your hand, like that.
Yeah.
And then roll it the whole way round.
Yes.
So you're sort of moving this hand so you find the point, because you want the nice sharp point for piping the icing. Okay, you find the point, you roll it under.
So you shove your two thumbs up there to try and get the point as well.
So you're keeping the point the whole way through. Actually, that one was crap.
Performance nerves, darling.
I do. I have performance nerves. We can do another one though.
By the way, how long are we having those gingerbread biscuits in the oven for?
10 to 12 minutes.
At what temperature?
I've got gas that's gas mark 6 or 200 degrees. So 200 it's higher,
degrees centigrade.
Higher than a sugar biscuit would be.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, and we've had them resting in the fridge after rolling them out. We've had
they have to be cold before baking.
We've got to put the holes in.
We'll do it in some
hot. Yeah, okay. Right, these have expanded a little bit too much in the oven because they got bicarbonate of soda in. We put them a bit too close together, but they should be fine. Mm-hmm. We haven't had these in the fridge quite long enough as well, so that's why
and also
think they got
the
a bit puffy.
Warmest dough, the last dough that we rolled.
It was the last one, so
it was a little bit.
I'm sure they taste nice, but we don't know. How do we know when they're done?
Golden brown, not burned on the edges.
Okay.
And firm.
Yeah.
So they're holding their shape. And experience.
They smell amazing.
Yeah.
I feel so Christmassy, don't you?
I avoid feeling Christmassy these days.
Oh, that's true.
I feel Hanukkah-y.
We just need some mulled wine.
Yeah. I think they're done.
They're done.
That's the beauty of
so they're flattening out a little bit.
Okay, I'm gonna put these ones in and I'm gonna grab the cooling racks.
Okay.
So I'd rather get them baked before I fall back.
That's the timer going off.
So,
but as they cool, they will harden.
Yeah, they do
harden.
Go. Take the piping bag, take the butter knife, put the royal icing on the butter knife, push it in. You hold it against the seam, pull the knife out.
Yes.
And then you fold it away from the seam, inwards like that, and then down. And then you cut the end off.
Brilliant.
Like so.
So just you cut the end off a little bit, yeah?
Yeah. Well, depending on the size of the line you want to pipe.
Okay.
Okay. So then you do a bit of practice one, and then you go. Ooh. It's a bit of a rubbish bag.
Looks fabulous, you make it look so easy. Okay, so we're going to learn how to pipe now, how to make lovely lines on biscuits.
That is going to fill the outline of harder icing and you get a nice flat finish. So it's good for doing the background to the detail.
Okay, so when you want it all filled out,
so
sorry, if you could do it that second, because otherwise I can't do the biscuit. Right, okay.
So you get the royal icing that you've already prepared. You get some of the lemon juice.
Yes.
Fresh lemon juice is good, but today we're using Jif.
Yeah.
Not in the bathroom. And so you mix in a bit of lemon juice. And what you want is something that's runny, but will hold its shape. So it's a bit of an art to get the right texture. But one way of telling, I remember this from when I learned, is so you've made it runny, but it's not liquid, it's not like water.
Yeah.
So if you put a blob and then run something through it, like like a pair of scissors, it should close the gap within 10 seconds. So actually that's a little bit too runny.
Okay.
So we'll put a little bit more of the raw icing in. I should have put less lemon juice in. So that's closed the gap too quickly. And then you have the trouble that it'll run over the sides.
Yes, so okay.
You need something that will hold its shape and yet be runny at the same time.
So okay.
A bit more raw icing, a bit more of a blob. Scissors.
Perfect.
Yeah, see that's holding a shape, but it will eventually
close up.
Run together. Maybe it's a bit not quite running.
So it's all about consistency and texture and.
Yeah.
So you pipe, to fill it, you pipe the edges first with a thinner tip, is that correct?
It can be any size tip. Actually, it's good for it to be a little bit thick because it has to hold, it's like a dam, it's got to hold the runny icing in.
Right.
Okay.
So we've got everything going on here. We've got Raphael playing with his Spanish Winnie the Pooh. We've got the washing machine going on.
Okay.
So I apologise for the sound.
Yeah, see that's right. That's closing but not too fast. So, I mean, a bit of variation is fine. It's
okay. So you just pour it into your piping bag.
Yep. Good. Close that as we did before. And you don't want too big a hole at the end because otherwise it will run out everywhere. So
okay.
A small hole, I'll hold it upright and then get your biscuit. And it can be, you can do it immediately after you pipe the outside line. It doesn't have to dry or anything.
It's really hard to get it smooth.
So you don't start up here and then do this bit. You've got to do it on one consistent line the whole way across because otherwise it starts to dry around the edges and you don't get the nice shape.
So you mean, you've got to just keep going.
Yeah, you keep going.
You can't stop.
And you do it from one side over.
Okay.
And we've piped around that hole so it can hang on the tree.
Lovely. Yeah.
And then, I think overnight is a good length of time for it to dry.
Really?
To be safe. And then a bit, once it's set a little bit, you can pipe over it.
Yeah.
But for it to dry and be transportable or packageable, you need to let it dry for a day or two.
Okay.
And that's it.
It takes a long time. It depends on the weather, I imagine, as well.
Yeah, humidity can make a difference. There you go.
Thank you, Michelle.
You're welcome.
I'm going to have a go now.
Do you?
I've just done one round the edges. So there's two textures of icing. One slightly stiffer to do the edges, and one more liquid to flood.
Yep, flood, that's what it's called.
That's the word, flooding.
Flood.
What's the edging called? The technical term?
I don't think I
don't know. Right, so now Michelle's going to show us how to start and stop with icing.
Mm.
Okay, let's go.
So a dot is, it can be as big like that.
Yeah.
Or as invisible as you need it to be, but it sort of anchors the icing like that. Otherwise, when you do it, it goes everywhere.
Yes.
So it can just come out. So you're starting it somewhere and you're finishing it somewhere.
Okay, so you kind of lasso it in there.
Yeah.
Ah, right, okay, yeah. I have had stray icing
with
problems.
Circles as well, so you can stop it anyway.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Thanks.
This is Michelle, whose business is called Lavender Bakery, and she is a baking guru.
I am indeed. I'm full of helpful tips, aren't I?
Absolutely. It's amazing what I've learned from you.
Mm-hmm.
But look, these are all my practices. It's not easy, really. Basically, I'm trying to control the icing bag, but you've got to like push it out and let it fall and follow the direction of how it naturally falls, if I've understood correctly.
Yes, go slowly.
With control.
Yeah.
And hold the icing bag a bit like you're holding a trigger, you know.
Yeah. Yes. And hold it straight. Like vertical.
So here are the finished iced piped ginger biscuits I made for my Scandinavian meal this Friday. I'm quite pleased with them. I need more practice, but I think they're a good start.